21 years. I got 3 kids. 18-year-old daughter, loves God, virgin, living right. 22-year-old daughter, got married 2 years ago, virgin, love God, doing real good. Got a 21-year-old son who gives me a lot of preaching material. Thank God he's doing good now. But when he was 18, he decided that he was going to set up his own rules. We have house rules, and then they create their own rules. Well, our house rule was, you cannot have anybody in your car that you do not know, and you don't ride deep. Do y'all know what deep means?
Yeah.
When you got a whole lot of people in your car, and especially young black guys, you don't ride deep, especially in our area, in the area that he was in. So he decides he's going to create his own rules and allow somebody to get in his car that wasn't supposed to be in his car. Well, they decide they're going to go to this fight, and the boy in the back seat pulls out a gun and shoots it up in the air. My son takes off thinking somebody is shooting at him, so he goes, and then the other boys in the car said, no, whoever this guy was is the one shooting. So he makes all of the boys get out of his car. He turns around to go turn himself into the police, you know, to go back to the fight to say, I ain't had nothing to do with it. Well, when he turned around to go back to the police, they locked my son up for attempted murder. So we land in the bed about 12:30 at night, and we get this phone call. My only baby boy. Mama's baby boy. Mama's perfect baby boy. Mama's boy who could do no wrong. Y'all know how we get, right? We get this phone call at 12:30 at night. I know all y'all ready to listen then. 12:30 at night from this detective saying that we have your son locked up for attempted murder. You think the first thing I did was pray? What I do? I lost it. I lost it. I ain't losing. I'm gonna tell y'all why in a minute. I gotta tell y'all this is funny. You know, I really lost it, like on the inside, lost it because my husband was the one who lost it first. So we have this rule: whoever loses it first can't go, the second person can't lose it. You know, one person has to stay. So we go to the courthouse, to the prison, and we wanted to see him. They wouldn't let us in because of the charge. They wouldn't even give him bail. So we looked through this glass, and they had, I could feel his name. They had my boy handcuffed, walking down, you know, this hallway with the police officers, you know, attached to him. My husband, he lost it. This ain't a long time ago. He 21 now. This when he was 18. My husband, he started banging on the window, Joshua! Joshua! I mean, he was losing. I mean, it was crazy. I mean, he was crying, it was horrible. So I'm standing there saying, babe, it's okay, we're gonna believe God, we can do this, we go, you know, let's go get somebody, we get, I mean, I just lost, I couldn't hang any longer. Well, my 19-year-old at the time came, we were all sitting in this room, and she looked at us, and she said, what are you doing? There's going to come a day and a time when you may not feel like fighting, when you may not feel like standing and believing God, but bless God, you better have somebody around you that'll get up in your face and say, what are you doing? You can do this. You can believe God. You can stand. You can make it. We did. Oh, okay. And we got ourselves together, and $80,000 later, my son is free, he's clear, they dropped all charges, thank God. Can you imagine if my husband and I would have stayed in that state of unbelief, crying and being believe